हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू जय श्री जवाजी ऑडियो बुक चैनल। नाउ वी आर कंटिन्यूइंग विद पार्ट 3 ऑफ द 7 स्पिरिचुअल लॉस ऑफ सक्सेस बाय दीपक चोपड़ा। सेकंड लॉ, द लॉ ऑफ गिविंग। द यूनिवर्स ऑपरेट्स थ्रू डायनेमिक एक्सचेंज। गिविंग एंड रिसीविंग आर डिफरेंट एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ द फ्लो ऑफ एनर्जी इन द यूनिवर्स, एंड इन आवर विलिंगनेस view that which we see, we keep the abundance of the universe circulating in our lives. This frail vessel, though emptiest again and again, and fillest is ever with the fresh life. This little flute of a reed, though has carried over hills and dales, and has breathed through it melodies eternally new. The infinite gifts come to me only on those very small hands of mine. Ages pass, and still thou forest and still there is room to fill. Rabindranath Tagore, Geetanjali. The second spiritual law of success is the law of giving. This law could also be called the law of giving and receiving, because the universe operates through dynamic exchange. Nothing is static. Your body is in dynamic and constant exchange with the body of the universe. Your mind is dynamically interacting with the mind of the cosmos. Your energy is an expression of cosmic energy. The flow of life is nothing other than the harmonious interaction of all the elements and forces that structure the field of existence. This harmonious interaction of elements and forces in your life operates as the law of giving. Because your body and your mind and the universe are in constant and dynamic exchange, stopping the circulation of energy is like stopping the flow of blood. When our blood stops flowing, it begins to clot, to coagulate, to stagnate. That is why you must give and receive in order to keep wealth and affluence or anything you want in life circulating in your life. The word affluence comes from the root word affluere, which means to flow to. The word affluent means to flow in abundance. Money is really a symbol of the life energy we exchange and the life energy we use as a result of the service we provide to the universe. Another word for money is currency, which also reflects the flowing nature of energy. The word currency comes from the Latin word correre, which means to run or to flow. Therefore, if we stop the circulation of money, if our only intention is to hold on to our money and hoard it, since it is life energy, we will stop its circulation back into our lives as well. In order to keep that energy coming to us, we have to keep the energy circulating. Like a river, money must keep flowing, otherwise it begins to stagnate, to clog, to suffocate, and strangle in its very own life force. Circulation keeps it alive and vital. Every relationship is one of give and take. Giving engenders receiving, and receiving engenders giving. What goes up must come down. What goes out must come back. In reality, receiving is the same thing as giving, because giving and receiving are two different aspects of the flow of energy in the universe, and if you stop the flow of either, you interfere with nature's intelligence. In every seed is the promise of thousands of forests, but the seed must not be hoarded. It must give its intelligence to the fertile ground. Through its giving, its unseen energy flows into the material manifestation. The more you give, the more you will receive, because you will keep the abundance of the universe circulating in your life. In fact, anything that is of value in life only multiplies when it is given. That which does not multiply through giving is neither worthy giving nor worth receiving. If through the act of giving you feel you have lost something, then the gift is not truly given and will not cause it increase. If you give grudgingly, there is no energy behind that giving. It is the intention behind your giving and receiving that is most important thing. The intention should always be to create happiness for the giver and receiver, because happiness is life supporting and life sustaining, and therefore generates increase. The return is directly proportional to the given when it is unconditional and from the heart. That is why the act of giving has to be joyful. The frame of mind has to be one in which you feel joy in the very act of giving. Then the energy behind the giving increases many times over. Practicing the law of giving is actually very simple. If you want joy, give joy to others. If you want love, learn to give love. If you want attention and appreciation, learn to give attention and appreciation. If you want material affluence, help others to become materially affluent. In fact, the easiest way to get what you want is to help others get what they want. This principle works equally well for individuals, corporations, societies, and nations. If you want to be blessed with all the good things in life, learn to silently bless everyone with all the good things in life. Even thought of giving, the thought of blessing, or simple prayer has power to affect others. This is because our body, reduced to its essential state, is a localized bundle of energy and information in a universe of energy and information. We are localized bundles of consciousness in a conscious universe. The word consciousness implies more than just energy and information. It implies energy and information which is alive as thought. Therefore, we are bundles of thought in a thinking universe, and thought has the power to transform. Life is an eternal dance of consciousness that expresses itself as the dynamic exchange of impulses of intelligence between microcosm and macrocosm, between the human body and the universal body, between the human mind and the cosmic mind. When you learn to give that which you seek, you activate and choreograph the dance with an exquisite, energetic and vital movement that constitutes the eternal throb of life. The best way to put the law of giving into operation, to start the whole process of circulation, is to make a decision that at any time you come into contact with anyone, you will give them something. It doesn't have to be in the form of material things. It could be a flower, a compliment, or a prayer. In fact, the most powerful forms of giving are non-material. The gifts of caring, attention, affection, appreciation, and love are some of the most precious gifts you can give, and they don't cost you anything. When you meet someone, you can silently send them a blessing, wishing them happiness, joy, and laughter. This kind of silent giving is very powerful. One of the things I was taught as a child, and which I taught my children also, is never to go to anyone's house without bringing something. Never visit anyone without bringing them a gift. You may say, how can I give to others when at the moment I don't have enough myself? You can bring a flower, one flower. You can bring a note or a card which says something about your feelings for the person you are visiting. You can bring a compliment. You can bring a prayer. Make a decision to give wherever you go, to whomever you see. As long as you are giving, you will be receiving. The more you give, the more confidence you will gain in the miraculous effects of this law. And as you receive more, your ability to give more will also increase. Our true nature is one of affluence and abundance. We are naturally affluent because nature supports every need and desire. We lack nothing because our essential nature is one of pure potentiality and infinite possibilities. Therefore, you must know that you are already inherently affluent, no matter how much or how little money you have, because the source of all wealth is the field of pure potentiality. It is the consciousness that knows how to fulfill every need, including joy, love, laughter, peace, harmony, and knowledge. If you seek these things first, not only for yourself but for others, all else will come to you spontaneously. Applying the law of giving. I will put the law of giving into effect by making a commitment to take the following steps. Wherever I go and whoever I encounter, I will bring them a gift. The gift may be a compliment, a flower, or a prayer. Today I will give something to everyone I come into contact with. So I will begin the process of circulating joy, wealth and affluence in my life and in the lives of others. Today I will gratefully receive all the gifts that life has to offer me. I will receive the gifts of nature, sunlight and the sound of birds singing, or spring showers or the first snow of winter. I will also be open to receiving from others, whether it be in the form of a material gift, money, a compliment or a prayer. I will make a commitment to keep wealth circulating in my life by giving and receiving life's most precious gifts, the gifts of caring, affection, appreciation and love. Each time I meet someone, I will silently wish them happiness, joy and laughter.